I'm Diana. You're watching Physics Girl. I have just received a package, a mystery package, from Rosanna Pansino, who's another YouTube creator. She did a moon landing cake, so she's a cool girl. Yeah. So here we go. You've been selected to participate in the Great Gift Exchange. Cool. And then there's a URL. Very mysterious. Do-do-do-do. Go.
Hey, y'all. I'm Alton Delaney, the world's most famous gift wrap artist and YouTube's representative, Giflamat presenter.
That's a great pun.
You have been selected to be a part of YouTube's Great Gift Exchange, where you and 11 other creators will participate in a chain of charitable gift giving. And as a gift, each of you will make a donation to a charity that is important to your recipient. Then you'll be whisked away to my whimsical wrap shop, where I'll teach you how to gift wrap the creator's donation.
Oh, cool.
In a thoughtful way. Now, you're probably curious about what's inside your present. Go open that dang thing.
A pie cutter with an I love pie on it, but specifically pie, the symbol, like 3.14. I love pie, which is true. Both counts. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. It's like a bunch of pie. Insert rhubarbitrary pun here. I love that. So clearly Rosanna knows that I love puns, and specifically puns with fruit, because I interviewed a lot of fruit during the lockdown. Wishing you a very cherry holiday. You're a great creator, and that's no lime. Turn this potential energy into pump kinetic energy. Oh, that's too good. To open me, give me apple. Give me a pull. Oh, it's a little box. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my goodness. This is so cool. All right, here we go. Rosanna Pansino has made a charitable donation to the Malala Fund in your name. That is amazing. The Malala Fund does incredible work for girls' education. This is awesome. Clearly, Rosanna has done her research. She knows that puns are the kiwi to my heart. Okay, let's check back with the rest of that video.
And now, without further ado, I took years of modern dance. Let's find out who your lucky gift recipient is. What? Oh, come on. Physics girl, your official gift recipient is the awesome Alex Wasabi.
Cool. Yes, I love this so much. Alex is a really fun creator. I'm so excited. I get to learn how to rap like this.
See you at the rap shop. Oh, my voice. See you at the rap shop and enjoy the train ride.
I think he and I are gonna make a great pair. Okay, that is enough fruit puns. If I left San Diego about 2 hours ago, I shouldn't have gotten to where there's snow so soon.
And so Diana rode on our wintry train.
Huh. This actually makes no sense.
To rap with Alton and her physics brain.
It's holiday magic. Speaking of magic, what's that I hear? That must be Physics Girl now. I'm so excited to work with Diana Cowan today. From a young age, she was very interested in science communication and about making science accessible to everyone, especially young women who really look up to her. Well, hello, Diana, and welcome to the wrap shop.
This is amazing. Thank you.
I'm excited to do some gift wrapping with you.
I've heard much about you.
Well, I've heard a few things about YouTube. Is it true that we're just stardust at the end of the day?
We are. We are all made of these exploded stars that in long, long distant past turned into all these elements that make up us.
Speaking of explosive, I think my mind has been blown just thinking about that.
Already.
Did you grow up in a family where gift wrapping was a big part of the holidays?
Oh, absolutely. I grew up in Hawaii.
Great,
so
fun.
We didn't have like the white Christmas or anything. I was such a nerd and I loved math. And I would just fold everything so precisely. So I was always like making the lines and the creases.
She and I are gonna get along just fine.
Well, Alton, I have a question for you. World's most famous gift wrap artist. Do you have a piece of paper?
Do I have a piece of paper?
Where are you hiding that? How many times do you think you can fold this paper in half?
I could fold this paper all day long.
All day long?
Yeah. Once, twice, three times, four.
That was four times.
Five, six.
Six.
Maybe seven.
Seven, he's getting out the shoe. Interesting. There's sort of an urban legend that folding a piece of paper more than seven times in half is impossible, but that's not completely true.
I have a feeling I'm not gonna be the only one doing teaching here today.
There's a girl, Brittany Gallivan, who's a high school student, really, really smart girl. She came up with an equation to determine how long a piece of paper would need to be and how thick it would need to be in order to fold it n times, like any number of times. I know an equation just appeared on screen, but don't be scared, I love the math. L, your length, equals pi times t, your thickness over 6, times 2 to the n plus 4 times 2 to the n minus 1. So cool. Using this equation, Brittany managed to fold a piece of paper in half 12 times, but it started at 4,000 feet.
Oh my gosh.
Long, and it was the thickness of a sheet of toilet paper.
That must have been one big roll of toilet paper.
But there really are some hard limits to this. If you folded a piece of paper in half more than 300 times, you would end up with a book with more pages than there are atoms in the universe. So that would be hard to fit in your backpack.
Wow, I promise you, Diana, today we're not gonna fold any wrapping paper more than seven times.
Okay.
So I know that your gift recipient is Alex Wasabi. Tell me what you know about Alex.
As a scientist, I have done some research. So here's a little bit about Alex. Alex Wasabi is a YouTuber. He's an incredibly positive person. His motto is actually, if you're not smiling, you're doing it wrong.
I love this. We're always smiling here at the Wrap Shop.
He likes to do vlogs and challenges. He just has a really fun channel and fun energy about him. Alex is a big supporter of the Make-A-Wish Foundation, and so I'm giving a donation to the Make-A-Wish Foundation in his name.
Oh, such a great gift.
Yeah, I also, for fun, I got a small little gift for Alex and his brothers because they're really big on family.
And I love that, so it's something for him to keep, and then it's something, the charitable donation, that's something that goes above and beyond. Really cool. Well, if you're ready, I was thinking we could head over to my gift wrap laboratory and do a little experimenting with gift wrap.
Yes, I'm so ready.
Now, I know you live in a scientific world, but here at the Wrap Shop, I like to have a little holiday magic. So if you would snap with me on the count of three. Mm-hmm. One, two, three. We disappear. Welcome to my laboratory.
This is amazing.
So I thought today we would start out by wrapping the thing that every young scientist would love to get for the holidays, the science kit.
Science kit, so many activities in here, so much learning.
Today, we will be using the Japanese art of furoshiki, which is wrapping with fabric. We'll be incorporating a common scientific fashion accessory, the lab coat. How are you at folding laundry?
I'm more of like a roll-up kind of girl.
We're gonna start with the lab coat. We're gonna slide this over as if we're dressing our lab kit. And now here's my new lab assistant.
So Diana, tell me, what are we cooking up in the lab today?
Some presents.
Ooh, my favorite.
And now what we're gonna do with the back of this, we're gonna fold it in just a bit.
Then you tape it on?
Yeah, I'm just gonna tape that down because the front of this is really gonna be the star of this show. I'm gonna flip that baby over.
All right.
And now we're going to take the sleeves and we're gonna tie them in the middle into a little knot as if this were our bow.
Oh, cute. Already nicer than any gift I've ever wrapped.
We're gonna slide the goggles down and around over this. Just gonna fit around there. It's a little stretching.
Oh, that's very cute.
And now we're gonna add one more little flourish. We're gonna add a little paper pocket square.
Is mine too thin?
Yours is actually better than mine. Yeah, so just like a little fold there, yep. And now you're gonna repeat
over
and over. Excellent. See, you're true to form. You are creasing between each one.
Uh-huh.
I love that. So now we're going to create a fan fold. Grab the ridges of that pleat. Mm. You're gonna pull it stronger with one hand than the others.
Oh my gosh, there's immediately so much geometry going on here.
Yeah, what is my angle there?
I'm up to 45. Ta-da.
And now we're gonna just tuck this into the pocket.
Oh,
now we
that
might have
is
to
so
go
cute.
Under the little strap.
Oh, I love it.
Ta-da.
And it's easy to take it to the party, too. You're like, ah, gotta go. I'm off to the holiday party.
That was so easy.
Here we are, back at the Rat Bench, where things are really gonna heat up.
I'm very excited.
And Diana, we are going to create something you may be familiar with, coming from the island of Hawaii, a volcano.
Yes!
This volcanic wrap is both an innovative and a thematic way to wrap the gift that really plays off of Alex Wasabi's explosive personality, because it's gonna blow up. I mean, we're gonna blow the lid off this thing. So the very first thing we're going to do is we are going to adhere this water bottle down to the center of our lid. And so you've got a glue gun there. Please tell me you've used a glue gun before.
Oh, have I ever.
Okay, good. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take this, funny, this is not a fashionable collar.
It's not the cone of shame.
You want it to fit inside the base. I think that's looking pretty darn amazing. Now, here we have a roll of volcanic rock paper. So with precision, crinkle this paper.
Oh my goodness.
Who taught you how to gift wrap?
Only the most famous gift wrapper in the world.
The world's most famous gift wrap artist. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put some hot glue around here, and then we're gonna just fold over the edge and press it into the glue, and then we're gonna work our way around.
I'm gonna probably burn myself, but
and please do not burn yourself, although it is a volcano.
Ah, true. We have to have something molten.
So I think our volcanoes are looking pretty good here. And now we're going to take these long strips, and these are gonna go around the edge of this and kind of give it a an island flare,
That's
if
so
you
fun.
Will.
I love working with you.
I think
that's the biggest laugh I've ever gotten for any of my puns.
That was a good one.
Oh man. It's looking like a thing.
It really is.
And not just a crinkled brown lump.
It looks great.
Thank
great
you.
Great job. But at the wrap shop, you know, we like to take it from good to gooder to the goodest. So I thought we would add some ribbons to this coming out like little streams of fire and molten lava.
I love it.
The trick to this is you just put a little dot of glue inside of the container and then this is like, so it gives it that little leap.
These bracelets, this gift for Alex, him and his siblings. These are actually made from orange carnelian.
Those are really cool, that's really pretty.
Yeah, they're really beautiful. They're actually a type of mineral. They're a mix of silica, quartz, and iron oxide, which is basically rust, and that's what gives them the nice orange.
Sure, they kind of have like a rusty color
exactly.
to them.
Some people believe it symbolizes family togetherness.
I'm sure he's gonna love those. I think you could maybe use some of the thinner ribbon and just tie those on, kind of like lava rocks.
I love it.
And they perfectly match the volcano, which is great. I don't even know what to say. You have created a fantastic volcano. And now I think we're ready for a little chemistry.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen this trick done in lots of science experiments, but what is the actual science behind that?
So we're mixing together baking soda and vinegar, which are an acid and a base. It's called an endothermic reaction, meaning it gets colder.
So really?
Despite the fact that it's always been in a volcano.
Right, right.
As these mix together, carbon dioxide gas is produced and it bubbles up and it expands and it'll actually push up out of the volcano explosively, we hope.
Really cool.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and put all your dry ingredients in there, baking soda first, and then I provided two different colors of pigment. And if you don't mix the pigment, then it can erupt in two different colors.
There's the red and here's the orange.
So you have the gift, which is the donation to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And I was thinking we could bind it up in this lava rock.
I love it.
Right, and that way when this erupts, this rock will come out. So I'll give you the lava rock.
Okay.
And then you can fold up your gift for Alex.
All right.
And put it inside the lava rock.
All right. That's awesome.
And that just goes down right in there.
Okay, I'm gonna.
No dust.
In there.
And then I'm going to create a stopper for you.
Oh,
so
excellent.
That doesn't come out.
Awesome. And so I just stuff that right here?
Yep. Of course, every good mountain needs a name.
All right. There we go.
Mount Wasabi. So now we're going to take our box and we are going to gingerly place it.
All right.
And now we're just
so
gonna bind all this up with some iridescent ribbon.
Oh, your loops are a little floofier.
That's because I'm a little floofier. Take the ribbon, You fold it in on itself and you cut up on an angle. Ooh. And then it creates that perfect little V.
Oh, beautiful. Look at that.
Ta-da.
You are profesh.
I think the only thing we need to do is add the invitation card for Alex.
Actually, I have to attach to the card that I brought. It's very nerdy. This is my black hole card.
Love a good theme.
Here's some fun facts about black holes. They actually trap light. So the gravity from a black hole will pull the light in, and then the light will never escape.
I don't even know what to say about that.
I thought this would be so fun because you can sort of hide a little card right in the center of that black hole.
Oh, excellent. Mm-hmm. So maybe that's where we'll put the invitation to Alex. We'll write it on the back of that because, you know, he likes a challenge, and that'll be a challenge to find it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll just stick this right in here. And now you can just slide that under the bow,
under
the ribbon.
Oh, amazing.
Might I just say, I've had so much fun hanging out with you today. I feel like I've learned so much from you.
Likewise. So don't forget to tune in to Alex Wasabi's channel for an explosive installment of The Great Gift Exchange. Happy physicsing. And?
As we say here at The Wrap Shop, that's a wrap.
I don't know if I was supposed to say it with you.
You were, but a little more enthusiastic.
Okay, sorry. I was like, that's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
Nailed it.
Ho, ho, ho. So physics girl taught Alton Newton's laws of motion. What would Alex think when he saw the explosion? You get it.
Today, I got a package from a fellow YouTuber.
Oh, it's Mount Wasabi.
One, remove tissue paper. Two, pour me in. Three, two, one.
All right, I just got this card from YouTube, so I'm going to open it up. Diana, all this holiday cheer does not need to end here. Choose one more creator for the giving train and let's start a whole new chain. That's cool. So I guess I have an opportunity to pick another creator. So I'll have to think about who I'm gonna choose.